I had some trouble with my headphones, and I was waiting to get some new headphones before I listened to this album. So it's a few days after it actually came out.
Hype the great, the picture painter. Now throw this on YouTube, producing only bangers. Caping for the underdog, shout out to the famous. Look how far we done come since Sandy and Amos. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. Then just click the bell so you can know when I go live. This is for the culture that we grew in love and know. Leave a comment with your thoughts. Enjoy the show.
Today, we gonna listen to Big Pokey's new album for the first time. It's been a while since Big Pokey dropped an album. I believe it was 2008, Evacuation Notice. But this album is called
Sensei.
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 Oh, Sensei.
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 When Sensei dropped, you better cop to this. Sensei, ripping eight times, setting me straight.
And it's Sensei,
you know my name. It's Sensei, I'm uncut, off the chain.
Now me and Sensei getting shots to the dome.
I call me Sensei,
a whole new Sensei.
It's Sensei, good fella, Cheeto seller, slank a straight a sweller, and sell a white or hard yellow.
And bought a drug with the Sensei.
Sensei done hit the scene, about to tear up the club.
Sensei done dollar.
Sensei.
Sensei's the lock chain.
Know how my men play Big E and Sensei.
Sensei shank niggas, the chisel they made.
C1 Sensei and D1 you bitch.
Make way for Sensei, I'm a upcoming legend.
Real. Sensei and Big T in the booth going off like a Glock 9.
Sensei in the ass like a brand new thong.
Sensei, oh man.
How long have you been waiting for a Big Pokey album? Have y'all been waiting at all? Here it is. That's the album cover. Let's just see. You could check out one of my earlier videos where I talked about Ball and Parlay here on the channel.
We're going Ball and Parlay.
All right. The first song is called Piped Up. That bass, it was a lot of bass.
They say they miss me, nigga, since I put the mic down. Yeah.
You get this a lot when somebody don't put out an album often, or they go a while, a stretch, without new material. You know, they tend to talk about that. Or if they, get criticism, sort of like Kanye with, you know, I want the old Kanye, that sort of thing.
Yeah, we clogging up the pipeline. Word on the streets, they miss me since I put the mic down.
So, produced by PUG Tunes. I don't know if that's how you say it. Is it Pug or PUG? It's all caps.
Once I blow through this tin, I got motor spin. Getting to it, and y'all be going out, I be going in.
I think that's like much too laid back and mellow for that first, you know, I'm back. But that I'm back punch, you just gotta, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, he's trying to show off his lyricism, you know, talk. Pretty much show that, you know, I'm really a spitter, you know, because that's what people like Big Pokey for. You know, you get into these debates of who's the hardest and do you have lyrical people down south. Folks gonna bring up Big Pokey, you know, in that category with, you know, lyricism and, you know, clever wordplay and stuff like that. But off top, you know, what I always think about with rappers like this, when you have that lower tone voice, you know, how you can actually get it to sit in the beat. And, you know, when I think of people from around that spot, you know, in H-Town, and, you know, I think of Trader Truth. Like, if you listen to a lot of his stuff, it's like, you know, you still want that low tone because that's where they are. But, you know, it's kind of hard. Not hard, but, you know, it takes a lot to really mix it where you can, you get clarity in the vocals of the songs, too. And he usually starts his albums off, you know, with this cool type of stuff.
I'm a H-Town nigga.
What's my name, nigga?
Yeah.
Now, see, this should have been the first song, you know, I think.
Crockboard, nigga.
And this is Mr. Lee.
Me, I'm a mob nigga. Hardest pit in the litter. That's on guard, nigga. That's on sport.
And from the first song, Piped Up, to this one, you know, the way it was a lot of bass, or low end on that first track, and I think his voice really stands out on this one more.
Turn it upside down and I'm a sippy.
How often do you hear scratching on the record nowadays? Let me know. So I'm guessing all of these parts that's in the chorus are from various things that Big Pokey done before, because I can't recognize the part from Man.
Turn it upside down and I'ma sip it. Give me a kilo and I'ma whip it, ship it.
That was kind of changed a little bit.
It's that Big Podina. I eat shrimps and chemo before I rock your arena.
If I'm not mistaken, that part is from Keep My Name Out Your Mouth.
It's that Big Podina. I eat shrimps and chemo before I rock an arena.
Turn it upside down and I'ma sip it. Give me a kilo and I'ma sip it.
Five seconds in, this is my favorite beat so far, you know, out of these three.
XO, thank you.
Only.
Been in a... So I'm guessing it's produced by DJ XO. It does say it's produced by XO. So if you know anything, or if you pay attention to the production, so I'm gonna go back to, let's say, the 90s and, you know, the 2000s, where you, regions or cities or whatever had specific sounds. One of the things you would see is that, to me, like, this bass line or the groove of this kind of feels like, I don't know how to say, maybe Atlanta, but I get like the Rick Ross type of feel. If you go back and you listen to how the bass lines were used, or how the certain type of, I guess, soulful or more rhythm and blues type production and rap was done, I don't think this was like the way H-Town done it back then. You know, that's just going from the top of my head right now of what I'm feeling. But if I went back and, you know, listened, then I could probably tell you more accurately. But that's just the sense I get.
Wipe your eyes, don't you cry. No, the snow's missing, nigga. Bitch, I'm back.
So the second part of that hook is the better part, for lack of a better phrase, I guess. Let me go back a little bit.
Yeah, wipe your eyes, don't you cry. No, the snow's missing, nigga. Bitch, I'm back.
I wish you would have kept on with that. Dun, 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 dun. Or held it. Dun, 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 dun. Maybe it was just rhyming. I don't know.
Fuck me laying it down on my dreams, bitch. I bet I won't swear. Fully activated, track back calculated.
So the first song, Piped Up, was talking about how he's been away from a while, you know, and he's back. And now we have another song talking about I'm back. You know, but is it back to the mic or back to the streets? You know, back to whatever.
Yeah.
So this is Mind Made Up, Big Pokey featuring Lil Kiki, D-Bando, produced by D-Bando.
Be one thing when it be on your mind, though.
So to me, it got progressively better and better. I think, which is sometimes rare, you know, that it would just happen to fall like that. But this, I like this track the most so far, you know, listening to the production, the beat.
Yeah.
I think it's a little too much bass for me, you know, because I do want to hear those instruments more.
My mind made up, my nigga, I'm going in. This game, I'll go get you some money and I play to win.
See, I like this style, you know, a little more punchy or staccato, you know.
God's gift from a trip when the fifth hanging. Yes. Trendsetter on that leather, keep the game changed.
You hear how the difference in how Pokey voice cuts through versus Lil Kiki? I'm gonna just go back real fast.
Take a spin, 30 ride clipping this ratchet, nigga.
See what I'm saying?
Wait, and the lamb sprayed. I keep the fam paid, cradle to the fucking grave.
I think it could be that there's so much going on with those vocals on the hook that, you know, it was competing with those other instruments in that same frequency range. Because you can hear it a little better back here. This is Stand the Rain by, you know, Big Pokey featuring Chucky Trill. See if you tell me who produced it. Vinny Blanco?
And we got us one, baby.
The bullshit.
For real.
Hello. I always find it funny when people say stuff like that. We got one. Or you got one.
That won't change a thing. I keep the G's there in my lane and I always keep my flag.
Hold up. It sounds like something. I don't know if it's a sample. Let me see if I can get my sample expert in here. What's the song that go, oh, I, oh, I? That's what this reminds me of.
They're saying in the back.
Yeah, but they cut it off.
Playing. It sounds familiar, but I can't think.
It's bothering me that I can't figure out what the song reminds me of. Not saying that it's like a sample or interpolation. It just reminds me of some other song.
Long little gator. Long little big mouth. Yeah.
Diamonds in the Sky featuring Chamillionaire, Killer Carleon, Kirk Cobain's Lisa Lee, produced by Donnie Domino. Wait, Chucky Trill from that last song died. He was killed in Atlanta around All-Star Weekend. Oh, about Stand the Rain, I did like that one the most, so it went up even higher. But so far, I don't think Diamonds in the Sky is going to do it for me. Like Stand the Rain did production-wise.
President on the line. Hold up, I'm like the President Kuwait. My presidents, they came. Where you at? I'm President Kuwait.
Chamillionaire is a beast. You know, I always put him up there when it comes to my favorite rappers. But he ain't doing it so much nowadays.
I make a sandwich quick. A stack of bread and lay it right next to a bag of chips.
The way that Chamillionaire started that verse, I thought that I wouldn't like it. But then, you know, he kind of changed up that little cadence a little bit. At first, I was like, oh, this is going to be subpar.
All these diamonds, I don't need them, babe. I told him back then.
Who is this? Is this Kirk Cobain's? To me, it, when I first hear it, it just sounds like Drake.
Mob style money gang, my nigga forever, we the shit.
Wait, hold up. It didn't rhyme, but I think he gonna rhyme the A from that last B or C.
Honey bun, mob style money gang, my nigga forever we the shit. I shine bright when it's night, I'ma keep it lit.
I know.
I swear to tell the truth, nothing but the whole truth.
I swear to tell the truth featuring Ready Made. Who is it produced by? PUG Tunes.
Nigga, I got the proof.
Now, I'm kind of laughing because people who know me and know anything about, you know, my music and how I produce or maybe used to produce, I love big music. I love it. And nowadays, it seems to have all been stripped down to like a couple instruments or maybe very subtle type instruments. But I like that big, big sound, kind of like what I'm getting here. And so, when I think about that, I think about how, like, maybe 10 plus years ago or around that, when you had, like, Dipset and stuff like that, they would have those types of beats, you know. And a lot of times it was samples and stuff. Sometimes it wasn't. But, you know, that's what this kind of reminds me of.
Croc Wolf. Eddie Coke.
Featuring Eddie Coke. The song is called Pressure, produced by Bruce Bang.
From a different cloud, my thread count and my texture. When you got thick skin, certain shit it don't affect you.
I like the flow on this one.
I know it's been a minute, but I'm back in the building. Same shit, different day. I'm just stacking.
Ooh, and that guitar come in like that. I have to go back so I can hear when it come in.
Cash, I'm a smash, I ain't giving a fuck. Now that's
pressure. So after hearing that, like, you had to wait to the last part of the verse. You know, it started with the hook. You had to wait to the last part of the verse for that guitar to come back in. But then when you get to the hook, I need some, maybe not that same, you know, riff, but put me some more guitar up in there, you know. like a melody guitar. Turn that guitar up. So, you know, I say turn that guitar up, but one of the things, you know, I see is the standards, I guess, in mixing nowadays, where you want to basically keep everything here. You know what I'm saying? And the dynamics, right? The differences between, you know, the volume and sounds are getting closer and closer, probably almost like this. But, you know, turn it louder. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think that would be acceptable if that guitar was just blaring in my ear. Not actually blaring, but you know what I'm saying. Lie About It featuring D-Bando. He was on Mind Made Up as well on this Sensei album, and it's produced by D-Bando. So it's like auto-tune and a vocoder or something on there that's, you know, kind of panned to the left, and I really like that sound. You know, I think that was nicely executed. Sounds somewhat distorted, but you could hear, especially when the music go off, the vocals on, you know, that part. I ain't got to lie about it, lie about it, lie about
it. Mr. Lee on the track, boy.
Know what I'm saying?
So we got Big Third and Chris Ward on Once Upon a Time, produced by Mr. Lee.
Big Third, aka Silverback Gorilla, nigga.
Yeah, if you don't know, I love organs. You know, one of the reasons why I love Pimp C's production so much, you know, and you might hear it in mine.
Good, you can miss me with that extra. All right. Packs coming in, get them gone like I'm Esper.
So, all right. It's kind of the evolution of, you know, hip hop and how, you know, we get to where we are with those heavy 808s and that certain pattern of them too. Doom, doom, doom. What you get there, you know, that it became popular because it gets a reaction. Like, you kind of have to have it if you want some of the younger people. But older people like that too. So you have that, and then you pair it with that old, I'm going to just call it old school style of rap, you know, because it's, you know, the drums. So when you rap like, you would play certain drums, then it takes things up, you know, a certain level. And that's why, or to a certain place. And that's why, you know, in the 2000s, once people in the South were able to get their music heard and get signed to major deals and be on TV and radio and stuff, that it really took off. And one really big and good example of that would be Lil Jon, right? So that's what's going on here, and it's paired nicely. It would be interesting to see if Big Pokey actually rapped like this on this song too.
Team full of troops, all my niggas shoot. Pull up on your block, choppers hanging out the roof.
And it could be, you know, kind of about what era you came up in, because like the way the rappers now are using the triplets and being more melodic with it, you know, that generation more identifies with that. So let's say, however music may change in about, let's say, 20 years, when somebody come back and doing, you know, those sort of cadences that are done today with the same sort of melodies, then they're gonna be like, oh, they done brought this this sound that I identified a lot with, you know, back, or, you know, more to the forefront again.
Yeah. You can't relate, good for you, the story of the have-nots. Houston ain't the barrel.
Don't miss that pairing of the organ and the piano, or it sounds like a piano. That thing, that is killing it. I like that. I like that. Mainly because of that beat, but, you know, they were spitting on that too. But Chris Ward is one of those, you know, does he really get brought up a lot when it comes to these conversations about, you know, hard rappers and stuff? But Big Third wrecked it though.
Know what I'm saying?
Stacks featuring Lil O, right as the Woe is coming out. But you know it's gonna be a Woe. Boogie Low produced this one. One thing I do like in music, you know, real music, right? That, am I going the wrong way? I do like that. And this is giving it to me. But I want it louder. It's hard to make out, you know, what this sample is saying. But I can hear the stack sitting high as the ceiling. But the part before that.
It's gonna happen when it's gonna happen. Keep hustling, quit whining.
I will admit this beat has me confused. You know, it seems like the sequencing is just confusing me. I don't know what to say. Like, I just wanted to do something else. Ask me what, I don't know. But, you know, they took out everything right here, but it seemed like an odd place to take it out. I'm going to go back a little bit so I can see.
Keep hustling, quit whining. The money.
Okay, it's the bass line came out. Let's see how long it goes.
Pressure ain't bust my pipeline. It made a diamond, nigga.
I think it's kind of like at the beginning of the bar, it's nothing there, and it kind of builds up with the no, and I just want to have something to give me there, you know, kind of how I said the doom, if it was like oom, you know, I need something there for me, and then maybe like when you take out the oom, you keep the oom. it makes sense to some people. So this is Get By, featuring Devin the Dude, produced by Claymaker. Now, one thing you will find with Devin the Dude, when people feature him, they're talking about smoking, and it'll be interesting to see if that's what this song is about. It's called Get By, so I'm not expecting it, but hey, who knows? I know Sheree knows this one. Dun, 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 dun.
I'm just 0 for 0 today.
Like,
I don't know where that's from.
That's why I smoke like I smoke. I'm getting high.
It's a lot of bass in this one.
Rolling while niggas fly. I'm dolo.
That flute reminds me of what's his name? Gil Scott Heron.
Easing your mind as you rewind your favorite track. Blowing smoke in the air as you're laying back.
I will say from that Devin the Dude album, the newest one, I can't think of the name right now. I'm so sorry. But I would rather this sound on that album. I don't think I got this sound on that album. So I guess it was kind of about smoking. Change Your Life featuring Eddie Coke. We have Eddie Coke on here again. He also was on Pressure, produced by Mr. Lee. I think that's 3 tracks by Mr. Lee.
To my bag, right?
My bag, right?
In the daytime, I'm out of looking for it with a flashlight.
With a flashlight.
This another one with that organ in there, but his style seems a little different. Like it's kind of trying to get into that faster rap that's popular right now. But you know, I like how he did it.
Bank throw, bossing up for a bankroll. When it's been, gotta keep it busy, cause a lot of boys be in gang mode.
All right, so I like the album. Mostly, or not mostly, I like the production on the album, the nice soulful beats, musical music, you know. What I found was it didn't have any amazing hooks, which says a lot where you could still like something and you're not just amazed by the hook, so then you just really kind of disregard the verses. So you had to have everything be well done, right? So let's say there's no amazing hooks, there's no super amazing verse or nothing, you know what I'm saying? But everything is up to a level where it just makes a good solid thing. I think this is a great album in terms of, you know, it being put together, the lyrics, you know. I just love that production. My favorite song would be Stand the Rain, and the one with that stands out is, I think it's the one with Big Third that had those organs, and he came on with that style that had Chris Ward on it. But I do like it. Y'all let me know what you think about this album. I don't know if I would be listening again. I'll be listening again probably for those 2 songs to try to figure out what they remind me of. And maybe I'll try to play them or something and, you know, get closer.
That won't change a thing. Change a thing. I keep the G's there in my lane and always keep my flag.
Hold up. It sounds like something. I don't know if it's a sample. Let me see if I can get my sample expert in here. What I was hearing was coming out hard. That part of the hook by 8-Ball and MJG. That's what I was hearing, you know, what it reminded me of. But the chords or other parts of the beat does remind me of something from the 80s or 90s. I still can't figure it out. And, you know, coming out hard samples Stay by Rufus and Chaka Khan. But this is just my first impression in my first listen. I probably will listen again. But this is my first impression. This is basically how I reacted to hearing it for the first time. So yeah, let me know what you think. If you made it this far, you might as well, you know, subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. Shout out to everybody who's been subscribed, who continue to watch, you know, my videos. But it's been great. I've been hyped. Catch you on the B-side.